Now that we have described the entropy of substances, we can start to put those together to predict the entropy change of reactions. One of the first things to consider when we're looking at a chemical reaction is whether we have any changes in physical state between the reactants and products. In a reaction where we create a solid as a product, and if we're starting with aqueous liquid or gas, we would predict a negative change in entropy. So remember, a negative change in entropy, or less than zero, means that we have a decrease in disorder or an increase in order. And that should make sense. We're starting with fairly chaotic aqueous liquid or gas, and we're creating a very ordered solid from it. So a precipitation reaction, we would predict a negative. On the other hand, if we create a gas, again as a product, when we've started with a solid, liquid, or aqueous, here we predict a positive change in entropy. Again, we've started with more ordered, slightly more ordered substances, and we've produced a very disordered, or very chaotic, or random motion gas. And so for this, we predict an increase in disorder. The visual that's shown here, we're starting with two aqueous substances. So we have potassium iodide combined with lead to nitrate. So you can see the leads and nitrates listed in here. When we combine those together, notice that the two aqueous reactants produced a very ordered solid. So this is a precipitation reaction that we predict our entropy to be negative. The next factor we can look at in reactions is whether we have a change in the number of moles of gas. In this reaction, notice that we have a diatomic molecule. And in the process of this reaction, we're just breaking that diatomic molecule apart. And so we have twice as many moles of gas on the product side as we did on the reactant side. So even though we have a smaller atom or molecule here in the product side, we have twice as many substances here. And so if we produce more moles on the product side than we do on the reactant side, we expect to see an increase in entropy, and that means we have a positive value for our change. Other summaries that we can use for prediction: decomposition reactions, such as the one shown here, we tend to predict an increase in entropy. Notice the key thing here is that they are all gases, and so we're not changing the physical state on top of that. So in general, decomposition, we predict positive. Hopefully it makes sense that when we reverse the process, a combination reaction would be predicted to be negative. So here showing the combination to form water. Again, these are all in the same physical state, so that's not a factor. When we predict the dissolution, dissolution is just a fancy way of saying dissolving. When we dissolve a solid in water, this actually depends on the type of solid. So I will never ask you to predict. Because we need more information. When we dissolve a solid in water, if it's a molecular solute like sugar, any molecule made up of non-metal atoms, the entropy will always increase for those, as we would predict. However, for ionic compounds, the change in entropy can either increase or decrease. So here we see that sodium chloride, when we dissolve that in water, we get a positive value. And that's intuitively what we would predict. However, notice that for aluminum chloride, we actually get a negative value here. And this is often very counterintuitive. The reason is, if you look at these images below, remember that when we dissolve a solid in water, that solid, that ion, gets surrounded by water molecules, called that hydration sphere. And it turns out that those hydration spheres around each ion can often be more ordered than the original ionic solid was. In other words, aluminum chloride, although it's an ionic solid, the crystal structure of that has more disorder in it than the ions that are surrounded by water. So ionic compounds can be positive or negative. These are the ones I will not ask you to predict. You can't predict them. They have to be calculated or given. So to summarize, when we are predicting the change in entropy for a reaction, entropy usually increases. This would be a positive value. For melting, vaporization, or sublimation, this is where we're breaking molecules apart and looking at their IMFs. Decomposition reactions and reactions that result in a greater number of gas molecules or greater molar mass of a solid. And then, of course, the opposite processes we would predict to decrease and therefore have a negative sign. And so at this point in class, I ask students to break out into their groups. And for the reactions or processes shown here, sorry about all of that. For these reactions or processes, I ask students to predict the sign of the change in entropy. So I will ask you to pause the video, predict your sign, whether it's positive or negative, and then explain why. Okay, so you should have had a moment to try to predict for each one. So for these, we'll review them and go over it and describe why. So the first one, we can look at our type of reaction. Notice in this one, we have a combination reaction. And so since we're bringing molecules together, we predict that we would get more order in this one, more order or a decrease in disorder, we predict a negative. So you can either write a negative or you can indicate that delta S is predicted to be less than zero. For the second one, we have two conflicting factors here. The key factor is the number of moles of gases, though. We do produce more moles of gas on the product side, and so we predict a positive value for our change here. However, notice the size of our molecule decreases. And for purposes of what we cover in this semester, our molecule size is always going to stay small enough that it would be a minor factor. So the fact that we produce more moles of gas is what determines the positive prediction here. In our third example, we look at our physical states. Notice we start with aqueous, solid, aqueous, and aqueous. We're just having solid and aqueous as our reactants. Sorry about that. And going to aqueous, liquid, and gas. So just looking at our physical states, we're going from very ordered reactants to very disordered products. And so we would predict a positive change for this one. In our fourth example, we just have a physical change. We have the sublimation of iodine going from solid to gas. So again, predicting a positive change here because we're increasing the amount of disorder as this process happens. In our next example, this one's actually very hard to predict. If you had a hard time determining, then you did it right. Notice they're all gases, so we have no change in state. And if we compare our number of moles, notice we have a total of 4 moles on our reactant side, and we still have 4 moles on our product side. And if we look at our sizes of molecules, there's not a huge difference. There's nothing that's dramatically smaller or bigger here. And so this one would be hard to predict, and for now it's safe to say that it's about equal. We'll actually use this one in a calculation so that we can verify that. And our very last one, hopefully, again, you recognize we have a combination reaction. Combination reactions in general, we predict a negative, but we can also look at our physical states. We start with solid and gas, producing a solid, and so that confirms that we would predict this to be a negative value.